Nizam's. We have a multivessel PCI case coming up from Nizam's Institute of Medical Sciences. Please watch.
At NIMS is headed by Dr. Sheshagiri Rao and has 10 qualified interventional cardiologists and 12 fellows under training. NIMS is the first center in India to perform a PTCA and an ASD device closure. The cardiology department in NIMS is one of the largest in India, performing around 1800 coronary angioplasties, 350 balloon valvuloplasties, and 50 pediatric interventions every year. Apart from this, the cardiology department also performs several pacemaker implantations, AICDs, EP procedures, and RF ablations.
Yeah, good evening. Am I audible there? Hello?
Hi, we can hear you.
Yeah. Welcome to NIMS. Today I have lined up a very interesting case. Here, this gentleman presented with inferior wall infarction 1 week back. And he presented to us with post-MA angina. And the angiogram showed LCX bifurcation lesion. So it's Medina 111. Here, today we are planning to use a side guard stent, Capella side guard stent, which is an innovative stent, which is a nitinol self-expandable stent on the side branch. The uniqueness of this stent is that at the ostium it flares, so that it covers the ostium of the side branch totally. Then we can put a main branch stent and cross through the stent very easily into the side branch and then do a kissing balloon.
Dr. Sheshagiri Rao, good evening. We have Dr. Manish Parikh from Colombia, Dr. Yeah. Amal Kumar Banerjee, Dr. Anil Dal, Dr. Pramod, and Dr. R.K. Singh on the panel. Please interact, they'll be interacting with you.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Thank you.
Now, I'll briefly tell you the product information a little bit before we go into the case. So, can you give us the details? So this nitinol stent is available in 2.5, 2.75 and 3.2 sizes. The lengths are 8 and 14 millimeters. Can you show the product? So the major advantage of this stent is it flares at the ostium and covers the ostium totally. And in the traditional crush technique, we'll have to crush the side branch stent in the main vessel, whereas for the side guard stent, the crushing business is not there. So we can easily cross into the side branch later for a kissing balloon. Next, go to the product information. Yeah, I think you can see the angiograms there. Show the angiogram. So yellow caudal angulation.
Yeah, we can see the angiogram now. This is
the yellow cranial angulation showing the very tight lesion in the circumflex artery just before the bifurcation, and it is also extending into the OM ostium and also into the main circumflex. So here the angle is almost around 70 degrees. The side branch is originating. The basic prerequisites for the side guard stent is the diameter of this side branch should be minimum 2.25 millimeters and the main vessel should be 2.8. The angle should be more than 45. And also the lesion at the side branch ostium should not be more than 13 because the maximum length available is 14. So these are the four prerequisites for this side guard Capella device. So you can see the device there with the sheath that is separated from the balloon. This is a self-expandable stent, but balloon is used to split the sheath. So it splits the sheath and then the stent would be released. So the sheath will be in between the stent and the vessel, but there won't be much friction when you are taking it out. So once the stent is released, then we can pull it out very easily. For this, basically, you will have to prepare the side branch ostium very well. Suppose if it is a fibrocalcific lesion there, probably we have to use a cutting balloon or sometimes even rotablator to prepare the side branch ostium very well. Then the capella goes easily, and it is a dynamic expansion there, so that there will be helps in positive remodeling of the side branch. It scaffolds and adjusts itself to the side branch configuration because it is self-expanding state. The next please. Can you show the animation there? Yeah. Here this dilating the side branch. And will be dilated the main vessel. Now the capella goes in. So it has two markers, one is the proximal marker and another is the distal marker. The proximal marker should be in line with the ostium of the side branch. So now it is released. So once you inflate the balloon to 12 bar, this it splits the sheath and stents get released. It flares at the ostium and it completely covers the side branch ostium. So there is no crushing business required subsequently. Now the main branch stent goes in. So once you expand the main branch stent, it approximates with the side branch stent very well. So while going in, finally you have to end with the forward movement only when you are advancing the main branch stent. Suppose if you overshoot the lesion, come back and go again a little forward so that the plates of the side branch stent will not get stuck in the main stent. That's very important. So after delivering the main branch stent, now you go with a wire into the side branch, wire into the main vessel is already there. Then we do a kissing balloon. So this concept will simplify the issue of bifurcation, the mini crush, all this. The older technique that is mini crush, and even with committed bifurcation stent, a little bit of carry now would be left uncovered. Whereas with this side guard technology, because it flares up around the ostium, it completely covers the ostium in toto. So that is the major advantage of this side branch stent. So here, during the waiting, we already dilated the main vessel and also the side branch. Yeah, again, they are repeating the animation. Now the side guard is opened up. It is flared up. The proximal end is flared up, and it is totally covering the ostium of the side branch.
Show these steps. Yeah, Dr. Sheshagiri, is there significant disease of the side branch ostium? I mean, if we review the angiogram.
Yeah, here. The circumflex is engaged with an XP guiding catheter, and we passed the wires stabilizer plus into the main vessel. Show it on the screen. And cogar into the side branch, that is obtuse marginal. Next. Go ahead. So we dilated the side branch with a 2.5 millimeters balloon, and also the main vessel with 2.5 millimeters balloon. Next.
We are at the stairs.
Yeah. So the main vessel is being dilated. Next.
Dr. Sheshagiri, yes. Here, Dr. Pramod.
So now the side branch ostium is very well dilated.
There is some
flap at the proximal lesion. Now we are ready to deliver the side guard. So here the size of the head branch looks at least 2.75. The side guard is available in
2.5, 2.75 and 3.25. Here you are preferring 2.75 side guard, which is 8 mm in length. Okay, give me the 2.75 side guard.
Dr. Sheshagiri, yeah. It is the view of many people here that if you deploy just one standard stent, you may be able to get away with it. What is your opinion?
Can you increase the volume or not audible?
Can you hear us?
Sorry, you're not audible. Just a minute. They are going to increase the volume. Please go on.
Good evening, Anil Dhal, Dr. Patnaik
here. Hi, Amar. Yeah. The question is whether one stent placed across the OM in the circumflex would suffice in this patient if we were not using a capella or a stent.
No.
Yeah, here the side branch ostium is 60% narrowed in LO caudal angulation. And being a very big branch, so we thought we would put a capella into this and stent the main vessel. It's so a very big branch, 2.75. Vessel.
So I do agree here that a two-stent technique is not unreasonable. Both are large branches. You know, the concern here may be which one is considered the side branch and which one is not. But my only issue with the dedicated bifurcation stent technology here is that this is a standard bare metal stent.
Yeah.
So using a two-stent technology in a bare metal stent strategy here. And I think that the restenosis rates could be considerably higher here because of the lack of DES.
Yeah, it is an Itinol stent.
Yeah, I think Manish, yeah, the data on this stent is still picking up because very few cases are there, and
there
are some data with the OCT as well from Gary Mins. One important thing they mention is not to aggressively predilate the branch before you deploy this capella stent. And as you rightly said, it's an Itinol stent, and when you add a drug-eluting stent into the main vessel, the risk of stent thrombosis remains to be addressed. And I think we have to be very compliant with the newer antiplatelet drugs in the patients.
Yeah, Pramod, preparation of the ostium is very important. We have prepared it with good dilatation. Now the stent is in place.
Yeah, because the osteo lesion is seen in only LAD caudal angulation. Other angulations, it is totally overlapped. So, can you show the LAD caudal angulation in the beginning, which is showing the osteo lesion in the branch? This one. Yeah. So, this lesion is extending even to the circumflex also, main vessel, and also into the side branch. So, here the capella is into the side branch. It has two markers. The proximal marker is should be in line with the ostium of the side branch. Ready?
Yeah.
You have to go in. Yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
Go to the other angulation. Hello, caudal.
Yeah, ST elevation.
Yeah, yeah. Patient has some ST elevations. Ready?
Yeah. Come on, come back.
One more. You are just pull back the capella. Now I think the proximal marker is in line with the ostium.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think position is good.
So what are your comments, please? So the proximal marker is in line with the ostium, or will you have to? One more injection, please.
Yeah, I think RAO caudal is a better view. That is differentiating both the branches.
Guiding circle. Guiding circle. Okay.
Aryocaudal, actually some overlap in the ostium is seen. Go to elevocranial, because the positioning is very important. The proximal marker should be in line with the ostium, otherwise the stent will not flare.
So the key in this, as in any bifurcation technique, is visualization and angulation of views. And here I think a good steep iliocaudal or an aryocaudal is the angle of view. I think a cranial like this is not going to show the ostium.
There is some overlap. Go to the iliocaudal. Ready? Think it's okay?
Yeah, it looks perfect. Yeah.
So is there a overlap or it's okay? The position is okay. I think you'll have to go.
Any
in
comment on the position? Position of this.
Actually, in this injection, your guide has come out. And I think you seat the guide again.
There was some ventriculization. It is purposefully.
Yeah, it is purposefully withdrawn because there is some ventriculization if you push the guiding in. Yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
I think you'll have to go in a little bit. Yeah.
Looks okay. Okay, sir.
I'll go to injection.
Okay.
Yeah, I think here it looks okay. Now you are inflating the stent, you will have to inflate up to 10 bar.
Already inflated.
Yeah.
Sinister.
So you will have to wait for 10 seconds before we deplate, because it splits the sheath and releases the stent. Again, we'll have to deflate and wait 10 more seconds so that the stent orients properly to the side branch morphology. This sheath that is split will be in between the stent and the side branch. So you may encounter some slight resistance while you are pulling out the catheter, but usually it doesn't displace this.
Would you like to reduce the LEO and the caudal a little so that we could see a little better? Because an extreme LEO caudal we can't see very well from here.
Caudal you want little.
You want
better
more
angle.
Caudal. Yeah, go more caudal.
Right.
We'll take it. Yeah, we'll take it. I'm removing
the catheter. So other options for this, if you're not going to use a dedicated bifurcation, is you can certainly have a balloon in the main branch, inflate that and pull back on the stent.
Yeah.
Try to get the ostium directly that way. Those are techniques that I use.
We can show that.
The tap technique, as we call it. You don't necessarily
Can you
need
focus
to
on this?
Another technique that will work very well in this case is a culotte stent technique. You could certainly use that too if you wanted to use a two stent technique. This is all again not
Here the you can see the sheath that is split.
Pramod, can you see the split?
Yes, Patnaik, we are able to see that. I think the
Hello?
Technology is very elegant because it is self-expanding and there is a sheath which encases the stent.
Yeah, can you see the sheath which is split?
Yes, yes. We've all seen the sheath.
Can you see the stent? Sorry, babe. This is sheath and balloon.
Yeah, we saw the sheath and the split sheath. We've seen it very clearly.
This is the sheath that is split. Ready? Yeah. Now the side branches were widely patent. So yeah, then we'll deliver the main branch stent. Give the 28, 3 into 28. There are three markers on the flared edges. They are platinum iridium markers. And you can see the markers also there. Yeah, go to the other angulation. No, hello angulation. Hello cranial, go to hello cranial angulation. ఇక్కడ వాల్యూమ్ కొంచెం పెంచమనండి. ఇక్కడ మంది
లోకల్
స్మాల్ టెస్ట్.
ఇట్స్ ఫైన్ సార్, ఇట్స్ వెరీ గుడ్. ఇప్పుడు ఆర్ఏ కార్డులు వద్ద ఈ స్టెంట్.
సో వాట్ సైజ్ స్టెంట్ ఆర్ యూ టేకింగ్ ఇన్ ద మెయిన్ వెసల్? యూ ఆల్రెడీ డిసైడెడ్ 275 ఆర్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎన్ ఆప్షన్?
Sorry, you are not audible here. There is some disturbance in the transmission, audio transmission. Can you be a little bit louder, please?
Anyway, right now we are taking Giant's V, Promus 3 into 28. 3028 for the main vessel.
Yes.
Yeah.
Volume. You cannot increase the volume, huh? Let's see, hello, pardon. Come to. So while going in with the main branch stent, sometimes the flares may slightly offer some resistance. So always you should end with the forward movement. So advance the stent beyond the side branch. So this is 3 to 28 promus element stent in the main vessel, main circumflex. I could pass it easily without any resistance. Ready?
Yeah.
You have to come back a little bit. Ready?
Yeah.
This is much more visible being platinum.
Yeah. The position is okay?
I think you have to come back a little bit.
Yeah, we'll check in RA.
Yeah. Ready? It should be all right, no?
We'll recheck in RAO.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
Yeah, I think we'll have to come back again a little bit and finally always end with the forward movement. That's what they recommend, because sometimes these players will get stuck in the struts of the main vessel stent. That's the reason why they always recommend you should end with the forward movement. So I'm coming back a little bit and again going forwards. Small test, please. Yeah. Yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
Yes. Is okay or?
No, it's okay, sir.
Still you are covering?
Yeah.
One more injection?
Yeah.
Yeah, that should be
fine.
Come to RAO.
Are you satisfied with this?
It's covering.
Yeah, I think the stent position is good. So we are going ahead with the dilatation of the
deploying, sir.
Yeah, deploying the stent, yes. Go ahead.
Yeah,
I think so. So the basic thing what they advise is that ostium should be prepared very well. It's better to avoid high pressure inflations after deploying the side guard. To get the optimum result, the side guard ostium should be prepared well so that the post and deployment kissing balloon inflations will be of lower pressure.
Can we have a final angio so that we are running short of time? We are left with a few minutes. We'll have that's a very good result.
Yeah.
Yellow cranial.
Come to other angulation, yellow cranial.
Yellow cranial.
Yeah, that's a great final result. So thank you very much for this very elegant demonstration of a novel technique. We now hand you back to Srinivas.
Thank you, Dr. Shesigiri, for the demonstration of newer stent and elegant demonstration of bifurcation newer stent.